Hello, my dear students. Myself, Miss Vaishali Dekate. I will be teaching you Maths in Standard 7. We are going to study Chapter Number 5, Operations on Rational Number, Practice Set 23.
Practice Set 23. See, children, above this Practice Set 23, there is one sentence. What is that sentence? There are innumerable rational numbers between any two rational numbers. So between any two rational numbers, we can find out, we can write innumerable rational numbers. We cannot count them also, and we can find innumerable rational numbers between any two rational numbers. But in practice set 23, we have to write three rational numbers that lie between the two given numbers. So two numbers are given to us, as you all can see, and we have to write three rational numbers. We have to find three rational numbers between these two rational numbers. So let us see. Sum number 1 is 2 upon 7 and 6 upon 7. I have written the sum. We have to find three rational numbers which lie between these two rational numbers, 2 upon 7 and 6 upon 7. So let us write the solution. 2 upon 7, numerator is 2 and denominator is 7. In 6 upon 7, numerator is 6 and denominator is 7. In both these numbers, you can see the denominator is same, denominator is common. When the denominator is common, it is very easy to write the numbers that lie between these two numbers. So, what we have to do, we will be first writing the smaller number, we will put a space and then we write a bigger number. As you all can see, the smaller number is 2 upon 7. So I am going to write 2 upon 7 first. I'll keep a space between these two numbers, and then I am going to write 6 upon 7. As denominator is same, we will be comparing numerator only, the integers which are there in the numerator. So in first rational number, numerator is 2. In the second rational number, the integer in the numerator is 6. So, which three integers lie between 2 and 6? If you observe the number line, I am going to show you the number line. Here you can see the number line where there is 2 and 6. Both are these positive numbers there on the right hand side of the number line. So, when you observe this number line, between 2 and 6, there are three integers, 3, 4 and 5, and as there is 7 in the denominator, and if I put the 7 in denominator of all the numbers, 1 upon 7, 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7, 5 upon 7, 6 upon 7, if in this way I keep on writing the 7 in denominator, still which three numbers we are getting between 2 upon 7 and 6 upon 7? Three numbers are 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7 and 5 upon 7. So we are going to write these numbers. So if you don't observe the number line also, what you have to do, you have to only see the integers in the numerator and write the integers which lie between these two integers. So after 2, 3 comes, after 3, 4 comes, after 4, 5 comes, and as the denominators are same, we put denominator 7 in all these numbers. After this, we put the comparison sign. What is the comparison sign? This is the comparison sign where we have to show 2 upon 7 is smaller than 3 upon 7, or 3 upon 7 is greater than 2 upon 7, then 4 upon 7 is greater than 3 upon 7, then 5 upon 7 is greater than 4 upon 7, and 6 upon 7 is greater than 5 upon 7. In this way, we have to show it by the sign of comparison. And then we can write the answer. Therefore, the three rational numbers, our question is, the three rational numbers that lie between, which two numbers are given to us? We have given 2 upon 7 and 6 upon 7. Between 2 upon 7 and 6 upon 7 are, which are those three rational numbers? These are the three rational numbers, 3 upon 7, 4 upon 7 and 5 upon 7. In this way, we have to write the answer. Now see the second sum. Two rational numbers are 4 upon 5 and 2 upon 3. See children, here we can observe that the denominators are not common. Denominators are not same. They are having the different denominators. When the denominators are different, how to solve? We have to first equalize the denominator. We have to first make the denominators equal. And after that only we can write the numbers which lie between these two rational numbers. So first equalize the denominator. For equalization of denominator, we will use the LCM method. We will be finding out the LCM of 5 and 3. So for finding the LCM of 5 and 3, we have to find the factors of 5. As you all know, 5 is the prime number. Its factors are 1 into 5. 3 is also prime number, so its factors are 1 into 3. That means there is no common factor. So LCM is the product of these two numbers. LCM of these two numbers is 5 into 3 is 15. So as we have got LCM 15, what we have to do? We have to first make these denominators of both the numbers 15. So first I am going to write first rational number 4 upon 5. How to make it 15? Denominator 15. When you multiply 5 by 3, we will get 15. So multiply 5 by 3. As we are multiplying denominator by 3, we have to multiply numerator also by 3. So 4 threes are 12. And 5 3s are 15. In this way, we have got 15 in the denominator of first number. Now, let us write the second number 2 upon 3. 3 is there in the denominator. 3 multiply by which number we can get 15? 3 multiply by 5, correct? As we are multiplying denominator by 5, we have to multiply numerator also by 5. So, what we will be getting? 2 5s are 10 and 3 5s are 15. Now, we are getting equal denominator. Now from these two numbers, as the denominator is common, we will compare the numerator numbers. In the numerator of second number 10 is there, in the numerator of first number 12 is there, that means second number is smaller. So I am going to write here 10 upon 15. I will put a space and then I write 12 upon 15. Now see children, what I told you, you don't have to look at the denominator. When denominators are equal, don't look at the denominator, only compare the numerators, only write the numbers which lie between these two numbers. So which numbers are there? 10, 11 and 12. If I put 15, so what does it means? 11 upon 15 is greater than 10 upon 15 and 12 upon 15 is greater than 11 upon 15. But see children, we are getting single number, only one number between these two numbers, and our question is to write three rational numbers which lie between these two numbers. But as we are getting single rational number, what we have to do? We have to make this denominator little bigger. How to make the denominator little bigger? You can multiply this denominator by any number. You can multiply denominator by 2, 3, 4, 5, whichever number you can multiply. So I will first multiply by 2. 15 multiply by 2. As I am multiplying denominator by 2, what I have to do? I have to multiply numerator also by 2. So answer I am getting 12 2s are 24 and 15 2s are 30. Same thing I will be doing for the second number. I will multiply the denominator by 2. As I am multiplying denominator by 2, I have to multiply numerator by 2. And I will be getting the answer 20 upon 30. Again, I am getting the common denominator. Again, I am getting the equal denominator. Now, from these two numbers, which is the smaller? 20 upon 30. I am going to write here 20 upon 30. Then I will put a space between these two numbers. I will be writing the bigger number now, 24 upon 30. Now, as you all can see, denominator is equal. And in numerator, integers are 20 and 24. So we have to write the integers which are there between 20 and 24. Both these numbers are positive numbers. So we will be writing all the positive integers which are there between 20 and 24. So which numbers are there between 20 and 24? 21 is there, 22 is there and 23 is there. Correct? So 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. In this way, you have to write three numbers. Now, below in denominator 30 is there, so I will be writing 30 in all these three numbers also. Then put the comparison sign. 20 upon 30 is smaller than 21 upon 30. 21 upon 30 is smaller than 22 upon 30. 22 upon 30 is smaller than 23 upon 30. And 24 upon 30 is smaller than 23 upon 30. So in this way, we have got three rational numbers which lie between these two rational numbers. Now 20 upon 30 we have got after calculating, after multiplying all these numbers. Which number? 2 upon 3. So in place of 20 upon 30, I will be writing 2 upon 3. Now 24 upon 30 is the answer of 4 upon 5. So in place of 24 upon 30, we have to write 4 upon 5. And these numbers which lie between these two numbers, we write them as it is. We don't change them. Okay, so we are going to write all the numbers as it is. And then now write the answer. Therefore, the three rational numbers that lie between 2 upon 3 and 4 upon 5. You can write like this also, 4 upon 5 and 2 upon 3. But as the smaller number is 2 upon 3, so I am going to write 2 upon 3 first, then and 4 upon 5 are which are those three numbers? 21 upon 30, 22 upon 30, and we have to put only comma sign here, and 23 upon 30. Third sum, minus 2 upon 3 and 4 upon 5. As you all can see, one number is negative and the second number is positive. So always you all have to keep in mind that negative numbers are smaller than the positive numbers. Always when you observe this number line, you all can see negative numbers are on the left hand side of 0 and positive numbers are on the right hand side of 0. So numbers which are on the right hand side are always bigger than the numbers which are on the left hand side. So, and it is also important to keep in mind that negative numbers are always smaller than the positive numbers. So these are the negative numbers, this is the negative number and this is the positive number. But still we cannot write the numbers which lie between these two numbers. Why? Because their denominators are different. So when the denominators are different, what we have to do? We have to equalize the denominator. For equalizing denominator, we have to first find out the LCM between these two numbers. LCM of denominators. So denominators are 3 and 5, 3 5s are 15, their LCM is 15, that means we have to make denominator 15. So first write minus 2 upon 3, 3 is in the denominator, 3 multiply by which number we will get 15, 3 5s are 15, correct? The LCM of 3 and 5, LCM of 3 and 5 is 15, correct? So we have to make the denominator 15. So as we are multiplying 3 by 5, we have to multiply minus 2 also by 5. So we are getting minus 10 upon 15. Now let us see the second number, that is 4 upon 5. 5 multiply by which number we will get denominator 15? 5 3s are 15. So as we are multiplying denominator by 15, we have to multiply numerator also by 3. For getting denominator 15, we have multiplied 5 by 3. So we have to multiply numerator also by 3. So 4 3s are 12 and 5 3s are 15. So in this way we have got equal denominators in both these numbers. So children, as I have told you, the negative number is always smaller number. So I am going to write minus 10 upon 15 first. I will put a space for writing 3 numbers and then I will be writing the bigger number, the greater number, which is 12 upon 5. Now we have to write the integers which lie between minus 10 and minus 12. So children, between minus 10 and plus 12, there are numerous integers. As you all can observe here, in the number line, minus 10 is here. This is minus 10 and this is plus 12. And between minus 10 and plus 12, there are various integers. Minus 9 is bigger than minus 10. Minus 8 is bigger than minus 10. So, in this way, if you keep on observing these numbers, we can see how many numbers are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 21 integers are there between minus 10 and plus 12. So you can write any 3 integers from this 21 integers and write 15 in the denominator. So I will be writing minus 8. You can write minus 9 also, minus 7 also, minus 6 also. It is up to you. So I will be writing minus 8, minus 4 and plus 6. Okay. Minus 8. Minus 4 and plus 6, and I will put 15 in all these numbers denominator and then put the comparison sign. Every time put the comparison sign. Minus 10 upon 15 is the bigger form of minus 2 upon 3. So we will be writing minus 2 upon 3 in place of minus 10 upon 15, and 12 upon 5 is the bigger form of 4 upon 5. So I will be writing 4 upon 5 in place of 12 upon 5. Now these numbers which lie between these two numbers, we write as it is. It is not 18, it is 8. Minus 8 upon 15, minus 4 upon 15 and 6 upon 15. And then write the answer. Therefore, the three rational numbers that lie between, which two numbers are given to us, minus 2 upon 3 and 4 upon 5, are minus 8 upon 15, minus 4 upon 15 and 6 upon 15. So in this way we have completed third sum. Now let us see the fourth question. Fourth sum is 7 upon 9 and minus 5 upon 9. Now as the denominator is same, we don't have to make the denominator equal. So we will be writing the solution. Smaller number we have to write first. As I have told you, negative numbers are always smaller than the positive number. That means minus 5 upon 9 is smaller than 7 upon 9. And here I am going to write 7 upon 9, which is the greater number between these two. Now keep on writing the integers which are there between minus 5 and plus 7. This is minus 5, this is plus 7. So after minus 5, which is the bigger number? Minus 4 is bigger. Then minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So again, there are how many numbers between minus 5 and plus 7? Minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. And then plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 6 plus 5, 11 numbers are there. So you can write any 3 numbers between those 11 numbers. So I will be writing minus 4, which comes immediately after minus 5. Before 7, there is 6. Okay. Then I can write minus 2 or plus 2. Okay. I will be writing plus 2 now. And then write 9 in the denominator of all these integers. Put the comparison sign. Write the answer. The three rational numbers that lie between 7 upon 9 and minus 5 upon 9 are, which are three rational numbers we are getting, minus 4 upon 9, 2 upon 9 and 6 upon 9. You can write any three number. It is not necessary, it is not compulsory that your answer and my answer should be same, because there are more than three numbers which are there between minus 5 and plus 7. Now let's see fifth sum. Fifth sum is minus 3 upon 4 and plus 5 upon 4. So children, in this sum also we can see equal denominator and plus and minus numbers are there in the numerator. So the negative number is always smaller, so I am going to write minus 3 upon 4 first. Then we will have to put a space between these two numbers and write the greater number, 5 upon 4. Between minus 3 and plus 5, which integers are there? After minus 3, there is minus 2, minus 1, then 0, then plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. That means there are total 7 integers between minus 3 and plus 5. So between those 7 integers, you can write any 3 integers. So I am going to write minus 1, plus 1, and plus 3. Put the 4 every time in all these integers in the denominator. Now put the comparison sign. So we are getting minus 1 upon 4, plus 1 upon 4, plus 3 upon 4. You can write minus 2 upon 4 also. You can write 0 upon 4 also. You can write 2 upon 4 also. It is totally up to you. Whichever number you can find between the integers in the numerator, you have to write those 3 numbers. So I will be writing the answer now. Therefore, the 3 rational numbers that lie between minus 3 upon 4 and plus 5 upon 4 are, which are those 3 we are getting? Minus 1 upon 4, plus 1 upon 4. If you want, you can put the sign of plus. Otherwise, if you not write, it is okay. And plus 3 upon 4. 6 sum, 7 upon 8 minus 5 upon 3. So again we have to find out the solution. As you all can see, again in these two numbers, one number is positive, the second number is negative. That means the negative number is smaller and positive number is greater. But as you all can see, the denominator is not equal. That means we have to equalize the denominator. That means we have to find the LCM of these two numbers, 8 and 3. LCM of 8 and 3. As you all know, between 8 and 3, there is no common factor. There is no common factor of 8 and 3. That means when common factor is not there, we have to multiply for getting the LCM. So 8 threes are 24. So LCM of 8 and 3 is 24. First write the number 7 upon 8. Now we want to get 24 in the denominator. So 8 multiply by which number? 24 we will get. 8 multiply by 3. As we are multiplying denominator by 3, we have to multiply numerator also by 3. So what we will get? 7 threes are 21. 8 threes are 24. So in this way we have got 24 in the denominator. Now let's see the second number, minus 5 upon 3. In denominator 3 is there. 3 multiply by which number? We will get 24. 3 multiply by 8. As we are multiplying denominator by 8, we have to multiply numerator also by 8. 5 8s are 40. Minus sign is there. We have to put the minus sign. And 3 8s are 24. So in this way we have got 24 in the denominator of both of these numbers. Now, as we all know, the negative number is always the smaller number. So we write minus 40 upon 24 and 21 upon 24 here, and we put the space. Now, as you all can see, 40 minus 40 and plus 21. They are, plus 21 is very big number as compared to minus 40. Minus 40 is very, very, very small as compared to plus 20. So there are many numbers between minus 40 and plus 20. Many. After minus 20, which number is bigger than minus 40? Which number is bigger? Minus 39 is bigger. Then minus 38 is bigger than minus 39. Then minus 37, minus 36, minus 35, minus 34. The list is long. Correct? So you can write any 3 numbers. It is not necessary your answer and my answer should be same. I am telling you all again and again. So after minus 39, I can write any number. I can write minus 25 also. Then before 20, there is 20. Before 21, there is 20. Then there is 19 also. So I am writing plus 19. then you can put 24 in the denominator of all these numbers and put the comparison sign and then write the answer. I hope you all have understood how I have written the integers in the numerator. As I have told you, there are many numbers between, see children, minus 40 and plus 21. There is minus 39 also, minus 38, minus 37, minus 36, minus 35. The list is big. Minus 34, minus 30, like that. And then somewhere 0 will come. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 till 19. So the list is very big. You can choose any three numbers between these integers and write over here. I have chosen minus 39, minus 25 and plus 19. So minus 40 upon 24 we have got by calculating minus 5 upon 3. So in place of minus 40 upon 24, I am going to write minus 5 upon 3. Then these three numbers we have to write as it is, with the sign of comparison. And then 21 upon 24 we have got by calculating 7 upon 8. And then now write the answer. Therefore, the three rational numbers that lie between minus 5 upon 3 and 7 upon 8 are minus 39 upon 24, minus 25 upon 24, and third number I have written plus 19 upon 24. Seventh sum. Five upon seven. 11 upon seven. Denominator is equal. Denominator is same. When the denominator is same, solving sum becomes very, very easy. Correct, na? So, we will be writing the smaller number first, which is 5 upon 7. Both are positive numbers, so comparison becomes very easy. Then we will put a space and we write the greater number, 11 upon 7. Plus 5 plus 11, very easy. Between plus 5 and plus 11, how many numbers are there? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5 numbers are there, correct? So in this 5, between these 5 numbers, among these 5 numbers, you can write any 3 numbers here in the integer. So I am going to write 6 upon 7, 9 and 10. Okay. So 7, 7 every time you have to put. Put the comparison sign and write the answer. Therefore, the three rational numbers that lie between 5 upon 7 and 11 upon 7 are, which are those three rational numbers which we have written? 6 upon 7, 9 upon 7 and 10 upon 7. 8th sum, 0 minus 3 upon 4. So let us see. Children, you all know 0 divided by any number, answer is always 0. So let's start the solution. If you observe this number line, observe the number line. 0 is there. On right hand side, all the positive numbers are there. On left hand side, all the negative numbers are there. So if I put 4, as 4 is there in the denominator of second rational number here. So if I put 4 in all these numbers, 0 upon 4, minus 1 upon 4, minus 2 upon 4 and minus 3 upon 4. 0 upon 4 means 0. 0 divided by any number, answer is 0. So between 0 and minus 3 upon 4, between 0 and minus 3 upon 4, we can see only two rational numbers, minus 1 upon 4 and minus 2 upon 4. So when we find only two rational numbers, what we have to do? We have to make the denominator bigger, correct? Because our question is, we have to find out three rational numbers. And here we are getting only two rational numbers. That means we have to make the denominator bigger. How we can make the denominator bigger? by multiplying the denominator by any number. You can multiply it by 2, you can multiply it by 3. I am going to multiply it by 2. So we are going to do here in the solution. First number is 0. As 4 is there in the denominator of first number, I will be writing 0 upon 4 here. Now second number is minus 3 upon 4. As we have seen, between 0 upon 4 and 3 upon 4, only two rational numbers are there. We have to make the denominator bigger. So we can multiply the denominator by 2. As we are multiplying denominator by 2, we have to multiply numerator also by 2. So 0 into 2 is 0 and 4 to the 8. Now we have to make this denominator also by 8. So 4 to the 8. As we are multiplying denominator by 8, we have to multiply numerator by, multiplying denominator by 2, we have to multiply numerator also by 2. So we will get minus 6 upon 8. So in this way, we have got 0 upon 8 and minus 6 upon 8. See, I am going to draw the number line here again. Here 0 is there, then plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6. And if you write on the left hand side, it will become minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and minus 6. So this is 0. 0 can be written as 0 upon 8 also. If I put 8 in all these denominators, I am going to put 8 in all the denominators. So what we are getting, 0 upon 8 and minus 6 upon 8. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 rational numbers between 0 and minus 6 upon 8. So you can write any 3 rational numbers between this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers. So the smaller number is minus 6 upon 8. So I will be writing minus 6 upon 8 and then 0 upon 8. You all know negative numbers are always smaller than 0. So between these two numbers, between minus 6 and 0, there is minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. So you can write any 3 numbers. I am going to write minus 5, minus 3 and minus 1. We will put 8 in the denominator, then write the comparison sign and then write the answer. But before writing answer, in place of 6 upon 8, what we have to write in our question, we have minus 3 upon 4. Minus 6 upon 8 is the answer of minus 3 upon 4 and 0 upon 8 means 0. 0 divided by any number, answer is 0. Then write these numbers again. Okay, and now write the answer. Therefore, the 3 rational numbers that lie between minus 3 upon 4 and 0 are minus 5 upon 8, minus 3 upon 8 and minus 1 upon 8. In this way, we have completed all the sums from practice set 23.
Thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to like and subscribe by pressing subscribe button.